Hello everyone, my topic is all about reflective array antenna, and I will discuss what is reflective array antenna. Reflective array antenna is an antenna, such as a billboard antenna, in which the driving elements are situated at a predetermined distance from a surface design to reflect the signal in desired direction. Reflective array antenna usually have many driven elements working in conjunction with an electrically large reflecting surface to produce a unidirectional beam. May be used to increase antenna gain, reduce radiation in unwanted direction, and may contain parasitic elements as well as the driven elements. A reflective array antenna consists of a large number of passive phase shifting elements placed on a plane or a conformal surface. Each element provides a total reflection to an incident wave with a certain phase shift. By choosing the phase shift of each element properly, the energy of an incident plane wave can be focused in the feed horn placed in front of the array, thus producing a reflector antenna. This picture is a kind of reflective array television antenna, which is very horizontally polarized, that consists of 8 bowtie dipole driven elements mounted in the front of a wire screen reflector. The X-shaped dipoles give it a wide bandwidth to cover both the VHF 174 to 216 MHz and the UHF of 470 to 700 MHz bands. It has a gain of 5 dB VHF and a 12 dB UHF and an 18 dB front-to-back ratio. And this picture is a reflective array billboard antenna of the SCR-270 radar. This is an early U.S. Army radar system. It has consists of 32 horizontal half-wave dipoles mounted in a front of a 17 meters high screen reflector with an operating frequency of 106 MHz and a wavelength of 3 meters. This large antenna was required to generate a sufficiently narrow beamwidth to locate enemy aircraft. This is the sample question that I gathered while I discussed this topic. Now, let's discuss the array antenna. The array antenna is a group of antennas connected in a range in a regular structure to form a single antenna that is able to produce radiation patterns not produced by individual antennas. The individual antennas, called elements, are usually connected to a single receiver or transmitter by feed lines that feed the power to the elements in a specific phase relationship. Array antenna is a set of multiple connected antennas which work together as a single antenna to transmit or receive radio waves. The radio waves radiated by each individual antenna combine and superpose, adding together or interfering constructively to enhance the power radiated in desired direction, and canceling or interfering destructively to reduce the power radiated in the other direction. Before I proceed, let's all know about the VHF and UHF antenna. The VHF and UHF antenna comes with the distinct pros and cons. Understanding this difference will help us identify the best signal frequency in the two-way radio needs. For instance, UHF antenna does not travel as per the VHF antenna, but may grant higher bandwidth occupation. All wireless communication systems, including cell phones and two-way radios, operate on what is known as operating frequency. Now, let's talk about the VHF antennas. VHF antennas, or very high frequency antennas, are designed to receive signals between 30 MHz and 300 MHz. VHF signals don't degrade as much as UHF signals, so they are used for longer range broadcasting. VHF is commonly used for FM radio broadcast, two-way mobile radio system, long-range data communication, and marine communications. VHF waves must not exceed the local radio horizontal of 100 miles. VHF frequency are less likely to be interrupted by atmospheric noise, issue with electrical equipment, and other interference. There are different bands within FH frequency, including the low band and high band VHF. Let's talk about the low band. In low band, VHF has a range of 49 MHz, including the transmission of wireless microphones, cordless phones, radio controlled toys, and more. Slightly, in high band, VHF has a higher VHF range of 54 to 72 MHz that operate the television channels in 2 to 4, as well as the wireless system defined as assistive listening. VHF frequency has a range of 76 to 88 MHz that operate the channel 5 and 6. The highest low band in VHF is 88 to 108 MHz and operate the commercial FM radio broadcast band. Now, let's discuss the VHF antenna common design. First, the multi-element Yagi antennas. This feature is a VHF television antennas used for broadcast television reception. These six antennas are a type known as a Yagi antenna, which is widely used at VHF. A Yagi antenna can have a gain of up to 20 dB, making them popular for a weak signal communication mode. Yagi antennas can be combined into arrays. The dipoles in a multi-element Yagi can serve double duty, acting as a director or reflector depending on the frequency band. Next is the log periodic antennas. The log periodic antenna is a high gain antenna that works on a broadcast frequency band. Log periodic antennas incorporate a number of active dipoles connected together in logarithmic mathematical formula modeled of an infinite spiral. This is the basis of a name of log periodic. Now, let's talk about the UHF antenna. The UHF antenna, or ultra high frequency, is send or receive signals between 300 MHz to 3000 MHz or 300 GHz. UHF radio waves are much shorter in length than VHF, measuring around in 12 to 24 inches. As a result, antenna length is reduced as well as the radio range. Anything from a building to a human body can interfere with the UHF transmissions. Dropouts and interference are far more likely, but greater bandwidth occupation is permitted. As a result, you may find a wider frequency range as well as the wide range of audio signal. Up to 250 milliwatts is allowed, exceeding the 50 milliwatts power restriction applied to VHF. UHF signals are usually weaker than comparable VHF signals. UHF radio signals are used in many facets of life, including satellite communication, GPS, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, walkie-talkies, cordless phone, cell phones, and television broadcasting. Now, we will discuss the UHF antenna common design. First is the fan dipole antenna. A fan dipole antenna has two triangular sheets of metal or rods that resemble a bow tie. They capture a wide bandwidth. Fan dipole tend to be longer than rod dipoles. A multi-band fan dipole antenna consists of 2 to 5 wave of dipole antennas mounted on a common parallel feed point. Next is the UHF reflector antennas. The UHF reflector antennas resemble a fan dipole antenna but have a signal reflector behind them. The reflector could be a mesh screen or solid reflector. The solid reflector may be a flat sheet or a parabolic reflector, and the parabolic reflector is a curve and concentrate the signal on the antenna. This can be improved the gain of a dipole antenna by up to 9 dB, increasing their power to 8-fold. And this is also the sample question that I gathered while I discussed this topic. And now the conclusion. Reflective array antennas usually have a number of identical driven elements fed in phase in front of a flat, electrically large reflecting surface to produce a unidirectional beam of a radio waves, increasing antenna gain and reducing radiation in an unwanted direction. And that's all. Thank you.